As of May 12th of 2024, there are currently 46 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is one less than last week. One of these erupting complexes can be found in southern Japan on the island of Kyushu, where the Sakurajima volcano towers several thousand feet above the middle of Kagoshima Bay. Sakurajima used to be a true island until it was connected due to a lava flow with Kyushu in 1914. Sakurajima is the youngest vent of a large caldera complex known as the Ira caldera and has been producing frequent volcanic explosions which often eject bombs of lava. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Peru, after a five-month pause in activity, the Ubinas volcano produced a new eruption, sending a continuous plume of ash to an altitude of 20,000 feet or 6,100 meters. Meanwhile, in Iceland, the longest, most voluminous, and most energetic eruption of the Reykjanes volcano has finally ended after 54 days of lava effusion. However, the rise of adjacent ground has pointed towards a conclusion that another new eruption from the same volcano may soon begin. And in what is this week's top story, Indonesia's Ibu volcano experienced a notable uptick in eruptive activity, creating unusually high ash plumes and resulting in its alert level being raised from 2 to 3. This change in alert level carried with it an increased danger of longer-reaching pyroclastic flows and the ejection of lava bombs beyond Ibu's crater rim, so as a result, its exclusion zone was increased from 2 to 3.5 kilometers to 3 to 5 kilometers. As a quick note, I want to remind everyone to not get as close to Ibu as shown in this footage as it is far too dangerous. The filmer of this, Extreme Pursuit, is a trained professional with many years of experience filming dangerous volcanoes, and he even went with a local volcanologist, which is why he can get this close and you can't. Now back to the video. Ibu, for context, I like to call the mining pit volcano because its frequent volcanic explosions look like planned detonations seen at an open pit mine. Typically, these energetic explosions result in the gradual building of its dacite composition lava dome and primarily keep its associated pyroclastic flows and lava bombs within its complex crater. This activity seemingly began increasing around March 28th, possibly due to an effective partial blockage forming at the top of Ibu's magma conduit. As a result, more gas and volatiles are able to build up before its explosions take place, resulting in fewer but far more explosive eruptions, which have the capability to send eruptive products up to 5 kilometers away. For example, one explosion late on May 11th not only ejected car-sized boulders of lava up to a kilometer beyond its crater rim, but also created Ibu's highest eruption plume in 6 years, reaching an altitude of 5,325 meters above sea level. Ibu is likely to continue such a high rate of activity for several more weeks at a minimum. Meanwhile, in Iceland, the spectacular eruption of the Reykjanes volcano, which began on March 16th and defied all expectations, finally came to a close. In all, 34 million cubic meters of lava was erupted, which covered 6.2 square kilometers of terrain. Yet, ever since the third day of that eruption, lava had been building up in its 5-kilometer depth magma chamber faster than it could be released. Typically, this magma chamber releases its magma via a magma run event, often leading to an eruption when it reaches a volume of between 8.4 and 13.8 million cubic meters. Well, as of today, this has reached a volume of 14 million cubic meters, a figure just above what triggered the most recent nearly 2-month-long eruption. As a result, in my opinion, I am fully expecting another magma run to occur in the next week, meaning we may have a new eruption occur in about the same location by May 19th. And in Peru, after seemingly ceasing its eruptive activity on December 15th, the Ubinas volcano unexpectedly erupted again earlier this week. This eruption occurred on May 6th, sending a sustained plume of ash to a height of 20,000 feet. While this is only 1,600 feet above Ubinas' summit, since it is a fairly tall volcano, the associated plume was visible from a satellite. This eruption continued for the next 36 hours, sending ash towards the south-southeast. Satellite thermal signatures at Ubinas have been increasing week over week after no such signatures were detected for more than 100 days. It is thus my opinion that shallow magma is rising towards the summit of Ubinas, meaning eruptive activity is likely to continue during the next few weeks. Here is the quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on May 11th of 2024.